Gold getting banged up again as we kick off the week, but why? Dish Network cooks up a plan to enter the phone business and a software giant that's working on a time machine. Hey everyone, I'm Lauren Lister of Yahoo Finance, coming to you live from the NASDAQ market site in Times Square. Four stocks you'll want to watch today coming up in just a minute, but first this morning's business headlines. Traders taking a large dent out of gold after falling into bear territory on Friday. It's dropped as much as 6.3% today to below $1,400 per ounce for the first time in 2 years. Yahoo Finance senior columnist Mike Santoli is in our newsroom now with a look at what the heck is going on. Mike, what do you think?
Well, obviously, gold was weak for a while now. It was unable to make new highs last year, even as central banks kept printing. That was sort of a little bit of a signal of what could have happened if, in fact, things got really negative for gold, which is commodity funds selling. I mean, I think that's the first line right here. Big investors that have a lot of profits over many years and some who just got in late and decided they wanted to try to play the boom are selling right now. Then you had a weak economic number out of China. China and India are really the two big net buyers of gold and silver, and they don't have as much excess cash sloshing around. Growth there is slowing. So all these things are kind of causing a self-reinforcing bear market in the precious metals right now.
Okay, and I don't want to end it there. We'll talk more about this in a moment with Yahoo Finance senior columnist Mike Santoli in just a few seconds. But first, a developing story. Dish Network is making a bid to buy Sprint Nextel. Dish is offering $25.5 billion for the cell carrier. SoftBank of Japan, you may recall, already has an offer on the table, but Dish CEO Charles Ergen says his proposal is much sweeter. Ergen has been trying to move Dish from the slow-growing pay TV business into wireless. Sprint Nextel's up more than 10% this morning. It was already trading near its 52-week high. And meantime, a number of other headlines this morning in the phone business. First off, Foxconn has stepped up hiring, suggesting that Apple is readying for a new iPhone. Also, BlackBerry is asking regulators to investigate claims that people are returning its new Z10 smartphones at an alarming rate. BlackBerry suspects it's a rumor meant to manipulate the company's stock price. Finally, Verizon is rolling out a new policy where customers have to wait 24 months to upgrade their phones. Now, the industry standard has been 20 months, even with a two-year contract. So you may have to wait a little longer if you have Verizon. Meantime, Citigroup beat the street with earnings released within the past half hour. The company posted earnings per share of $1.23. That beat estimates by 6 cents. The number is a 31% rise over last year. Now, this is the first full quarter under new CEO Mark Corbett. He replaced Vikram Pandit, who stepped down under pressure from the bank's board. And we'll be back in a few seconds with a look at four stocks to watch throughout the trading day. First, overseas markets, which are under pressure. Markets in Asia led the red today after some weaker than expected economic data for China, which Mike mentioned, and indexes in Europe too have been down. So are futures here at home. Let's take a look for now at four hot stocks the Yahoo Finance team will be watching for you today. First up, Life Technologies, which is up close to 8% in pre-market trading here on the NASDAQ. So this is on the news that Thermo Fisher is now nearing a deal to acquire Life Tech. Now, we first told you about this plan last Wednesday when it appeared an alliance including Blackstone Group would try to outbid Thermo Fisher. But it appears that proposal never materialized. Life Tech is now at a 52-week high. It rose nearly 2% on Friday ahead of this morning's gains. Next up, Hanes Brands, which will be reporting earnings today. So this company hit its 52-week high just on Thursday, but dropped more than 2% on Friday ahead of the report. Hanes Brands, if you don't know, is the parent of several apparel labels, including Hanes, Champion, Bali, and of course, Wonder Bra. It recently inked a big deal with Macy's and is set to get more shelf space at Walmart too. Now, the stock is up roughly 35% year to date, climbing most recently on news that it's about to start issuing dividends. Now, Boeing, which has made quite an ascent this year, even with the trouble surrounding its grounded Dreamliners. And today, the FAA will order inspections on more than 1,000 of a different plane, the company's 737s. Now, the agency is responding to reports that an anti-corrosion layer was not applied correctly to pins used on movable tail panels. Boeing shares hit their 52-week high last Thursday and are now just shy of $90 a piece. Finally, Myriad Genetics, which is unchanged in pre-market trading. A case involving the Utah-based company goes before the Supreme Court today. At issue, whether Myriad should be allowed to keep its patents on two human genes. Opponents say, hey, no company should be able to patent what are essentially part of the human body. They argue Myriad's monopoly has stood in the way of medical progress. But what do you think? That's the subject of today's poll. So vote below, and we'll be back in a few seconds to talk more with Mike. Let's check back in with Mike to talk about why gold is getting hammered and more. So, Mike, I know you mentioned China. You mentioned the outflows from commodity funds. Gold is something that's emotional, though, and people say, oh, this means that central banks have won, and it's not a safe haven, and we don't need it, and it's worth nothing, and gold bugs are wrong. So I want to know, to separate what you think are kind of these bigger picture issues having to do with fiat currency and that debate and central banks' success versus kind of these dynamics that are going on right now with China growth and reports that Cyprus may sell their gold from their central bank, things like that.
At a high enough price, gold becomes pure money, which means it's pure faith, right? It's not a commodity anymore. We don't need it for anything. So at this high a price, above $1,500 an ounce as it got to last year, yes, it means it is all about the faith in paper money and therefore central banks that print it. Now, paper money's been doing very well. We really haven't seen new highs in gold relative to stocks since it seemed as if European and U.S. central banks were actually not going to surrender control of the system in 2011 after the euro crisis. So it seems to me right now we're having a gut check on that reality. Mm-hmm. Can gold endure these things? And you know what? On the way up, it was said that it was a store of value. It was sort of a last resort type of currency. Well, if it was that at all, it remains that at this lower price. You can't have both a perfect store of value and something that goes up every year 10 years in a row. It just doesn't make sense.
It's a good point. It's a great point. Let's move on to something that may not make sense either. Dish, what do you make of this possible bid to acquire Sprint? Is this for real? We were kind of talking about this earlier that it may not be.
Well, there is an actual deal on the table for Sprint. SoftBank's going to buy 70% of Sprint. That's a deal. It's going to be voted on in a couple of months. Now, Dish comes in and says, we'll pay you 12 or 13% premium to what you're going to get for the whole company. Now, there is a strategy on paper that makes sense here, which is to add Sprint's wireless services and the wireless spectrum that Sprint owns through Clearwire to Dish's portfolio here, be able to offer customer a quadruple play, internet, wireless landline, entertainment, all the rest of it. So it is real in the sense that if it happened, it would actually make strategic sense. It would be expensive. The thing is, it's not a finance deal. He doesn't have the money in hand. They have a letter from the bank saying we can raise the money for you. So it's a little bit of a late stage. The other wrinkle, and it's unclear if this plays in at all, is that, of course, the yen has crashed since this deal was struck, and SoftBank, based in Japan, is the buyer right now. I don't think it compromises their ability to do the deal, but maybe Charlie Ergen at Dish sees an opportunity there.
Okay, we'll see. And Citi beat estimates with its earnings. What were the drivers? How did they do so well?
It actually was more of a Wall Street story. So their investment bank, their corporate finance business, was the source of the upside surprise in earnings. It looks like a generally clean number, even though cost cutting was a significant part of it. It's probably a slightly cleaner number than J.P. Morgan and Wells had last week, simply because it wasn't just about lower credit reserves. So this is a work in progress. They're still trying to shrink headcount. There's a new CEO in there only for a few months, Mike Corbett, who is going to have to decide if this bank ultimately is going to retain all of its global ambitions or if it's going to shrink a little bit more into something more localized, like an emerging markets bank and a corporate bank in the U.S.
What do you think?
I think it will get trimmed down a little bit more, but I don't think they're going to surrender the U.S. retail banking franchise in any respect.
All right. Thanks so much, Mike Santillera, senior columnist. Finally, the time may be coming for Microsoft. The Wall Street Journal reports the company is working on designs for a new watch. The paper says the device would go face to face with a time machine being developed by Apple. Word is Microsoft ordered prototype parts from Asia, but is yet to decide whether to move ahead with the project. Apple, meantime, is expected to unveil a watch later this year. And that's our Hot Stack Minute for this morning. We're out of time. I'm Yahoo Finance's Lauren Lister. We'll see you back here again tomorrow.